Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this tutorial, I will show you how to make a Wordle image and how to combine that Wordle image with a photo of Abraham Lincoln to create Wordle art. Here are some other images I have done using this method for Leonardo da Vinci and Theodore Roosevelt. This tutorial uses black and white Wordles and portrait images. In a future video tutorial, I will work with colored Wordles and portraits. Here is a quick tutorial overview. We'll start out by creating a Wordle image on the Wordle website. The text used is from the Gettysburg Address. Next, we'll cut out the letters, distort them, and color them. Then we'll take an image of Lincoln and crop it, adjust it, and make it a sepia style. Finally, we'll place Lincoln in the image, then make opacity adjustments and apply adjustments with the camera raw filter. To begin the project, we need a word cloud. Browse to wordle.net. Click Create. Paste in some text. I used the Gettysburg Address. Add a few words describing the image, such as Gettysburg Address and Lincoln. Put a tilde between the word Gettysburg and the word Address. That will force the two words to appear one after another. Duplicate Gettysburg Address and Lincoln a few times, so that they will appear three times. This will make them appear larger in the Wordle. Before continuing, inspect the text and insert any tildes that you want. In this case, I put a tilde between four and score, and also between seven and years. I also repeated four score and 7 years so that they would appear larger. Press Go. A random word cloud will appear. Next, choose Color. Choose White on Black or WB. In the Options menu, choose Font. I chose Beryllium as it looks quite historic. Then choose Layout. Choose Straighter Edges. And then choose Mostly Horizontal. At this point, keep pressing Re-Layout with Current Settings in the Layout menu until you find a word cloud that is fairly rectangular with not too much black space at the sides. When done, click the Save as PNG button. Save the file as word.png. Open the Wordle picture in Photoshop. Choose Image Size. Change image resolution to 300 pixels per inch. Double-click the background layer. Name it Letters. Save the image as a PSD file. To select the letters, choose Select Color Range. Select Shadows. Move the Fuzziness slider to 0 and the Range slider to 18. For your picture, play with the Fuzziness and Range sliders until the letters are clear. Check the Invert box. Click OK to load the selection. Duplicate the selection. Name the new layer Letters. Press D to select black as your foreground color. Choose the bottom layer. Fill it with black. Name it BG. At this point, we'll distort the letters a little to help fill up the image. Select the Letters layer. Choose Edit, Transform, Distort. Drag the letters up near the top of the image, then drag the letters down near the bottom. Place embed the portrait image. Name it Lincoln. Rasterize it. Next, we will crop Lincoln out of the image and add a sepia style. First, turn off the eyes of the letters layer and the BG layer. To make it easier to see what's happening, make a new layer below the Lincoln image. Fill it with 50% gray. Make the Lincoln layer active. I use the Quick Selection tool, with Sample All Layers turned off, to select Lincoln. Here is the resulting basic selection. Then select Refined Edge. Make the view on black. Choose Smart Radius of 8 pixels. Choose the drawing brush and trace around the edges. Set Smooth to 2 pixels. There is some backlight on some of the edges. To remove, set Feather to 3.3 pixels and Shift Edge to minus 18%. Change Output to Layer Mask. The settings for your image may differ. The cutout looks pretty good, but you can tweak it using the mask. Press D to make black your foreground color. Select Lincoln's mask. Use a soft round brush about size 50. Touch up as needed. Here I remove some fuzz outside the left arm. Press the X key to change the foreground color to white. Use this to add back any missing color areas. Once you're happy with it, delete the 50% gray layer, as it is no longer needed. Duplicate the Lincoln layer. This improves the quality of the image. Then merge the original and the duplicate. Rename it Lincoln again and add a layer mask to it. Next, we'll apply a sepia style to the image to give it some color and an antique look. Add a color overlay layer style. Make the color E1D3B3. Make the blend color. Lower the opacity to about 51%. Turn on the eyes of all the layers. With the Lincoln layer active, choose the Move tool. Zoom out a bit. Move Lincoln to a position off-center. Then resize him. changes opacity to about 82%. Next, we will color the letters. Make your foreground color BFA361. With the letters layer active, control-click the letter's thumbnail. Fill the selection with the foreground color. Deselect. Back to the Lincoln layer. Double-click the color overlay settings. Change the opacity to 92%. Finally, we'll make an adjustment to the overall image with the camera raw filter. With the top layer active, press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, plus E to make a composite layer. Right-click and make it a smart object. Choose Filter, Camera Raw Filter. Here are the settings that I used. These may vary for you depending on the portrait you are working with. I changed temperature to plus 16, contrast to minus 2, highlights to plus 6, shadows to plus 2, whites to minus 13, blacks to minus 26, clarity to minus 25, vibrance to plus 5, and saturation to minus 2. Here is the image before the camera raw adjustments. And here it is after the changes. This concludes the tutorial. Hope you've enjoyed it.